I'm Helen Scott and I'm Curator of Fine Art for the City of Edinburgh Museums and Gallery Service based at the City Arts Centre. And I've selected an artwork by Wilhelmina Barns-Graham from the 1980s. In the City Arts Centre's collection, we're fortunate to have three works by Wilhelmina Barns-Graham, but my own interest in this artist and connection with her work stems from a point before I was working at the City Arts Centre. Previously, I used to work for the Wilhelmina Barns-Graham Trust. I was taken on in 2005 as a research assistant to undertake a full catalogue inventory of the art collection from the artist's estate. Having worked quite closely with Wilhelmina Barns-Graham's artworks and having gone through pretty much the entire collection earlier on in my own career, I found it really difficult actually to select one particular artwork representing even just one decade within her work, because her artistic practice is incredibly rich and diverse and varied in terms of the different media she's using and in terms of the different subject matter and styles in her work as well. The artwork that I've selected to represent the 1980s is called Two Island Series Number 2 Orkney. It's an oil on board with a bit of pencil involved as well, and it dates from 1987. Barns-Graham first visited the Orkney Islands in the mid-1980s. She went there in 1984 for an exhibition of her work at the Pure Art Centre in Stromness. And the story goes that having gone up there to see the launch of the show, she decided to stay longer than she'd originally intended and actually do some work in the local environment. Now, Barns-Graham really kind of fell in love with the Orkney Islands, and this was a significant point in her career because it was the first time really since the 1950s that she had gone to a new place and been really inspired by that specific location since really the 1950s when she'd been visiting Spain and the Balearic Islands. Now, this artwork dates from 1987, so it's a little bit later on from some of her other earlier Orkney pieces. But she produced quite a spectrum of different works, all based on her experiences in Orkney. There are very large landscape drawings of the harbour around Stromness. There's a whole series of reliefs and collage works based on the rock formations there. And there's also a number of oil paintings, such as this one. This one is a fairly representational view of the Orkney. Others are much more abstract in their response to the landscape. Now, this one is a bird's eye view, an aerial view of the Orkney Islands, where she's sort of schematized the landscape into this geometric structure, this kind of patchwork of browns, ochres, greens, and yellows. The two spits of land are divided by these bands of kind of grayish blue green tones representing the sea and the sky. And they stretch all the way from one side of the picture plane to the other, giving a real sense of the breadth of that horizon. I love the contrast between the two different elements within this painting, the depth of tone that she achieves in the sea over here, contrasted with the sort of geometric structure, the quite rigid crystalline sort of network of this patchwork of fields in the distance. It was through Barns-Graham that I actually visited the Orkney Islands myself for the first time in 2009 when we were installing the exhibition The Discipline of the Mind at the Pure Art Centre in Stromness. And I travelled up a few days before the launch to see the show going up. This was an exhibition of her drawings, but we also had a supplementary display of works that were specifically inspired by Orkney, such as this one. And this was one of the paintings that actually went up for that show. And I remember seeing it in the gallery space in Stromness and thinking just how beautiful it was within that space, where you've got the light from the harbour, which is directly outside the gallery, coming in and bouncing off the white gallery walls. And you had the sense of the purity and the clarity of the light that you see in Orkney, and the way that Barns-Graham had achieved it in paintings such as this one. Being able to display a selection of Barns-Graham's Orcadian works actually back in Orkney, there was something quite magical about that in terms of bringing these works full circle, if you like, back to the source of their inspiration. This painting in particular is one of my favourites, if I'm allowed to have favourites. Because it does remind me specifically of that visit to Orkney in terms of looking out of the window on the plane when we were actually flying down into Kirkwall when I was working for the Barns-Graham Trust. And I remember looking out the window and seeing the landscape coming into view and being really struck by how similar the view was to paintings such as this one. I'd always assumed that in a landscape like this, Barns-Graham had really exaggerated the geometry of the landscape and sort of manipulated it. But actually, when you're up in the air and you're looking down on this network of fields, it is remarkably faithful to the actual landscape. It wasn't that she was manipulating the landscape per se, it was more that she was tapping into it and drawing out some sort of essence of the landscape and portraying it in a way that was really pure and really clear and really honest.